Hello, it's me again, and my convict cichlid has got some eggs in her crystal palace there that I made her. See them on that rock right there? Sorry, I stirred the dirt up just a little bit just a minute ago. But the moss, she got in there, you see them right there? And she's fighting to keep out the placostomus. She's only got two access points right there that they could possibly get in. There's the daddy. He was in there last night and fertilized them, so he's helping to keep everybody away. I'm just hoping that her babies do good. Maybe she'll be able to keep them up underneath that rock there. I hope I've got it designed up good. And we've got the Crebenza male right there. And there's one of my Julies. There's the other female convict cichlid. Hoping it'll lay some eggs soon. And I'm really liking my, can't remember what their name, but their water circulators. They really doing a good job. And right there, I made this crystal cave with skulls right there for my Julies. And she's taken up in there. I'm pretty sure she's going to have babies soon. Got me a little dinosaur hatching up there with my sculptures I done. That's real eggshells that I done with him. And we've got another Julie. She's right there, she is. And she really likes this cave right here. The only thing about these water circulators is they get that moss on them, but I figure that's helping to filter the water pretty good. So anyway, we go back over here. Oh, and I've cleaned up just a little bit, trying to get this place a little bit more feng shui. It's the most unfeng shui house on the face of the earth, and I've got to get this place looking better. There's my duck phone. Anybody with any show's got to have a duck phone, right? There's Snow, our koi. We're going to keep her in here until she gets too big for this tank. We're going to put her down there with Shadow. There's Big Daddy back there. He's blocking that placostomus. Placostomus has got eyes on those eggs. He likes eggs for breakfast. Don't you, boy? She keeps the dirt fanned off of them and keeps them aerated. There's a couple of my live birds. I've got all these guppies in here for extra food. We've got some ghost shrimp breeding in there. There's another dinosaur in the weeds there. He's hiding, eating a monkey. That monkey down there that he's about to attack. That's a female Crebenza. And see, most fish, the red belly means the red on them, the extra colors means that they're male, but in this species it's not. Those sharp anal fins down there, I can't remember the name of them. See, the side ones are pectorals, and then you've got the dorsal fin, but I don't know what the bottom ones are. But anyway, there's one female and here's another. And then the convicts also have pink on their belly. She's full of eggs. So I need to go ahead and get me another male to go with her. And they really love this current. They'll get over there and swim in it and gives them some extra exercise. It's sort of like a treadmill for fish. Let's see if one of them. Come on, Snow. Somebody get over there and get on the treadmill.